Amen. How many knows God is good?
Amen.
How many know the greater is He that's in us than He that's in the world? Amen. I thank God for the blessings and goodness, and I thank God for the Spirit here tonight. And I tell you, how many got the victory tonight?
Amen.
So how many got the victory tonight?
Amen.
How many got far shut up in the bones tonight?
Amen. Amen.
All right, praise and worship. Come and give us a couple of songs, and we're going to worship the Lord tonight. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
I got fire, shining in my mouth. I got fire.
Yes, hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 6 verse 19. I thank God tonight we have an anchor. We have an anchor in our soul, praise God.
Yes.
That anchor is Jesus Christ. I'm here to tell you, if you got Jesus tonight, you have an anchor in your soul, glory to God. And the Bible says in chapter 6 verse 19, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, which entereth into the that within the veil. Praise God, I'm here to tell you, he's sitting on the right-hand side of the Father, and he made a way for everybody.
Yes,
I said he made a way for everybody. There's no excuse, amen, for anybody to be lost. Can I hear that again? There's no excuse for Jesus dying, amen, for us all. The Bible says God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever lives in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So all we've got to do is believe and accept him tonight. I thank God for that. I'm going to preach just a little bit tonight. Amen. When you are at the end of your last knot. Now, truth, this is an old saying long, long time ago. And I tell you, this has kept me going a million times. Can I hear an amen? It's probably kept you going. I tell you, church, it's amazing how people today, especially sinner people, amen, they wait till they get the last knot and no place to go. And all they can do is look down. And sin has them bound. And they seem hopeless. I'm telling you, people today, now, Lord, give me this message tonight. Because somebody, amen, under my voice, not just in here to church, but or listen to me tonight. Somebody needs this tonight. You're at your last knot. You're thinking about committing suicide. You're thinking about giving up. But I'm here to tell you, you don't have to give up with Jesus. If you just let him give your sin and give your life and surrender your life to him, he's your hope tonight. He's got you held on by that last knot. And I want you to know tonight that he's ready to save you. He's ready to deliver you. There's nothing impossible for God. I said there's nothing impossible. You tried drugs, but drugs, amen, didn't set you free. You tried alcohol and everything else in this world, but it didn't set you free because of the devil. Even though you tried, see, some people tries to live right, and people tries to let go of this bondage, and they got their last knot in their rope, and they don't know what else to do but just give up. Don't you give up tonight. I said, don't you give up until you hear my voice tonight. You don't have to commit suicide tonight. You don't have to end your life tonight. Jesus is the beginning of your life. And you need to just, amen, give it to him. And church, he'll give to Jesus said in Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. What did he say? Yoke up with me. All you got to do tonight is yoke up with Jesus. I'm going to tell you because the Bible says, amen, that those are heavy burden laden, you can come to him. And he said, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I believe somebody needs this tonight. You need to hang on and give it to Jesus and believe in Jesus tonight. That's why Jesus came, amen, to destroy the devil, all the works that he's doing right now. He's come to steal, steal, and destroy, and he's destroying your life. But Jesus, I've come to give you life and life more abundantly. Oh, it's time to turn your life around. It's time to give your life to Jesus. Don't you give up. Just hang that last knot. You give it to Jesus, and everything is going to be all right. Can I hear an amen? Amen. See, the Bible says God is able to save to the uttermost. That means you don't have to, I don't care how far in sin. I don't care how bad you've done. I don't care how bad your life is. God is ready to forgive you and to set you free because he come to the amen to save to almost the other, well, to the uttermost. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 7, verse 25, wherefore he is able to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing he ever liveth to make an intercession. Amen for us. Oh, they could tell the world. And church, let me tell you, my brother said a while ago, actually a lot of people believing, amen, that Jesus is a myth and that Jesus didn't die. But church, let me tell you something. He died if you believe he died and resurrected and set him on the right hand side of the Father. I'm going to tell you, if you just give your life to Jesus and surrender to him, I'm going to tell you he'll set you free. He'll break the bondage and the yoke. Amen. I said he'll break the bondage and the yoke and he'll give you life. And he said, I'll give you life and life more abundantly. All you got to do is come to Jesus. All that last, thank God for that last thought. Thank God you still held on. Thank God for his love. Thank God for his mercy. Thank God for his goodness. Because he's living long enough that you can hear my voice tonight. And since come to Jesus and turn your life. I believe this tonight, church. God, give me this just for you tonight. That's about to give up. Don't you give up. Don't you give up. Oh, glory to God. The Bible tells us. See, sometimes we're so desperate. I said we're desperate. And we're at that last knot. But church, let me tell you something. All we've got to do is give it to Jesus. If you're desperate tonight, you have no kinds of troubles, and your marriage isn't in a wreck, and everything else tonight, I want you to know something. Jesus, come, amen. He said, just humble yourself before the Almighty God. Recognize I can't do it on my own. When I come to Jesus, I recognize I couldn't come on my own. I recognize if I didn't have Jesus in my help, I wasn't going to make it. And thank God I built an old-fashioned altar. All you got to do is just kneel down and say, Jesus, I'm desperate tonight. I'm at my wit's end tonight. And I have all kinds of problems and everything else. And you're my only hope tonight. I'm here to tell you, if God is your only hope, that's when you need to seek Him. That's when you need to come to Him, glory to God. The Bible says, humble yourself, amen. Therefore, under the mighty hands of God, cast all your cares upon Him. Why? Because, church, let me tell you, He's a God that careth. And, church, I'm here to tell you, He cares about everyone here in this building tonight. He cares about everyone that's hearing my voice tonight. Because, church, I want you to know, you may be hanging on that last knot, but, church, I'm here to tell you, God was merciful to you. God was being good to you. And God's giving you another opportunity and another chance. And don't you give up, I praise God. Don't you end this, because God's got good things in store for you. I'm telling you, church, we need to pray, amen, for the people that's lost tonight. We need to have a burden for the lost. To church, people don't even have a burden anymore, amen, for the lost. We got people hurting and desperate, and I'm ready to just give it all up because they haven't seen nothing. But I'm here to tell you, there's a God out there alive tonight. There's a God that understands tonight. There's a God that loves you tonight. There's a God that said, don't you give up and let the devil have his way in your life. You come to me, and I'll lift those oppressions up. I'll lift those oppressions up. If you come to me, glory to God, I'll give you life that you never had life. Life is abundantly. Life is a blessing. The Bible says, glory to God, if we'll come to Him, He'll shield us with favor. I thank God I've got favor tonight. I thank God you got favor tonight. I thank God He'll give you favor. All you got to do is give your life to Jesus. But that last thought represents the mercy and the grace of God. Oh, you listen to what I'm saying tonight, glory to God. Oh, I thank God tonight that He's touching people's hearts and lives right now. I thank God He's reaching forth right now. I know this is a sinner's message. This is a message of this desperate. This is a message that you need tonight. And God said, I'm giving you another opportunity and another chance. I can bless you, and I can set you up in life, and I cause you to have a blessed life, and you can have a full meaning of your life. Oh, I thank God tonight, church, that He's a loving God. He's a merciful God. He's our fortress. He's our shield. He's our high tower. He's our blessing. He's everything to you. But you got to surrender your life to Him and give it to Him, because He wants to bless you. Thank God for that grace tonight. Thank God for that little knot tonight. That the only thing is hanging you by threads. But God said, I love you enough to give you another opportunity. So take a chance on this opportunity. Amen. Oh, they're dying. Young people are dying by the thousands. They have no hope. They're taking dope and alcohol and drugs and everything else. And they have no hope, church. But they ought, if we as God's people, going to tell them and show them. The trouble is, church, the world can't see a lot of times. Amen. Our lives, like I said this morning, we are written pistols and read of all men. If we don't have hope, how can we give anybody else hope? If we don't have happiness and joy and peace and trust in God, how do we expect the sinner and the lost? Amen. Are you in the down and out? I'm here to tell you, church, we've got a friend tonight. I said we've got a friend tonight. And He'll sit close to us, glory to God. So the Bible tells us now, church, I believe people are not only desperate, but I believe they're oppressed and they're depressed. They have oppression upon them because of their sin. Sin will cause you to have oppression. Sin will cause you to be depressed. Amen. The devil will cause you to have oppression. The devil will cause you to be depressed. Are you listening to what I'm saying, church? But oh, we've got a friend, and His name is Jesus. You have a friend tonight. You may feel like it. Nobody cares for you, and nobody understands you, but you've got a friend tonight. And church, I thank God I've got friends tonight that what I've got confidence in. I thank God, I got friends tonight I can go to when I'm in trouble. But church, as much as I love my friends, there's no better friend, glory to God, than his name is Jesus. Amen. He'll listen to you in the midnight hour. I said he'll listen to you in the midnight hour. He's going to help you. Amen. That's why Jesus came. He came to seek and to save those that were lost, those that were hurting, those that were held in captivity, those that were depressed and oppressed. That's why Jesus died. Amen. The Bible tells us in Acts chapter 10, verse 38, amen, Jesus was anointed of God. Are you listening to what I'm saying, church? And the Bible says he went about doing good and healing all those, amen, that were oppressed of the devil. See, we got a world today, and see, the devil has blinded them, made them feel they don't have no hope. And they're helpless and everything because of the oppressive, depressive spirit. And it's on the rampage, church. Yeah. I said even a lot of God's people are being oppressed. But Jesus came to set us free, Brother Mark. And yeah. He wants us to be free. Yeah. Oh, I thank God for my prayer called Jesus. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Amen. The Bible tells us, seeing that now we have a great high priest that has passed unto heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession, for we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with our infirmities. And you out there, I'm going to tell you, those that may be oppressed and depressed, Jesus went through all these things. The Bible says he was tempted in all things, but yet he didn't sin. Yet he didn't give up on God. Yet he didn't let go of God. He knew who to go to. I'm going to tell you tonight, I can tell you where you need to go to. And his name is Jesus. He's the best friend that you could ever have. And all you got to do is just say, Lord, I surrendered all to you. That's all he wants. What you do. He said, you surrender my life, your life to me, and I'll bless you coming, I'll bless you going, I'll set you up in heavenly places, I'll turn your life around. I don't care how bad your life is, Jesus can turn it around and set you free and put you in heavenly places. And you say, that's the best thing I ever did, and he's the best friend I ever have known. He'll never let me down. He'll never let you down. I'll give God the glory. Praise God. For we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities, but with all points, amen, tempted like we are, yet without sin. So let us there come boldly. That's all you got to do is come boldly. Amen. Oh, if you're oppressed tonight, depressed tonight, if you have problems tonight, you're ready to give up tonight, you're ready to end your life, and you're looking to drugs and alcohol and sex and everything else, trying to find freedom, a little bit of happiness, you will not find it. I said you will not find it, because Jesus is our peace and our joy. He's everything that we need, and we need to give it to Jesus. But he says, come boldly before the throne of God, that you can find grace. He's the only place that you can find grace, that you can find forgiveness, and you can find hope, and that has come to Jesus because he died, amen. He was a man full of grace, amen, because he wanted us, amen, to have grace when we come to him and needed him. I'll give the Lord a hand clap tonight, church. Therefore, come boldly to the throne of God that you may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Now, God didn't give you this message. In fact, it's only about 30 minutes before service. Amen. I didn't get to write the scripture down for Sister Angie. But I'll tell you, I believe with all my heart, people, somebody need to hear this. Somebody need to grab a hold of this tonight. You're about to end everything, but yet God gave that one little merciful knot that you can hang on to. You hear my voice tonight. You can hear the voice and the anointing of God and the wooing of God's Spirit tonight, that you can turn your life around. All you got to turn to Jesus, all you got to do. Amen. The Bible says in Psalms, in closing by chapter 5, verse 11, but let all those that put their trust in thee rejoice. Let them ever shout for joy because thou defendest them. Let me tell you, church, that devil won't defend you. Some of your so-called friends won't defend you. Are you listening to what I'm saying? They've got you nailed. They've got you down and out. The devil has used them, got you hooked on drugs and alcohol and everything else, and then they'll leave you the first time they get a chance. Amen. When you have down and out and you can't help them, you can't help yourself, they'll leave you standing. But you know what? I thank God that Jesus won't leave us standing. Oh, I said he won't leave us standing. Glory to God. He'll be with us through the thick and the thin, so we can't give up on Jesus. Can I hear an amen? He'll defend us. Glory to God. Let them also that love thy name be joyful in thee. For thou, Lord, will bless the righteous with favor, with thy compassion, with a shield. You are compassionate tonight. You want love tonight. You want a blessing tonight. All you got to do is come to Jesus.
Amen.
Just get your heart right with God. I said, all you got to do is get your heart right with God. I feel God's anointing tonight, his spirit. People not in church, I tell you, there are people right now so oppressed and so depressed of Satan and with guilt and everything else and sin and everything. They don't know what to do. I tell you, I worked with the guy, bless his heart, and I worked with him that day, and he was so depressed and everything else, and he just kind of put on the front just because a person smiled and everything, said that everything was going all right. It doesn't mean that everything's all right. I talked to him about the Lord, but I wish I'd have had another opportunity that day to talk to him again, because that night he went and hung himself. He gave up on life. He gave up and he tried drugs. He tried alcohol. He tried everything in the world. The church, it didn't work out. The devil had him bound and blind. He got people bound and blind tonight. But church, I'm here to tell you, God can set you free if you just come to Jesus. Would you stand tonight? Leave that going, Sister Lizzie. No, I'm telling you, if you'll bow your head right now, while the church is praying to be praying for you, and while they're praying, and you're bound by drugs and bound by alcohol, and you're hanging on that last knot, that mercy, that grace, that knot's called grace or love, I'm here to tell you tonight, God is willing to save you. This message for you, I said this message was for you, and you need to come home of it and let go and give it to God, because he's going to set you free if you just come and bow your head and say, Jesus, you're talking to me. Jesus, I feel the Spirit. Jesus, you're going to accept me now. All I got to do is say, Jesus, forgive me my sin. That's all you got to do. Jesus, forgive me my sin and set me free. Change my mind. And the Bible says he'll give you a new life. Oh, Heavenly Father, God, tonight. They may have oppression spirit. They may be depressed tonight. They may be having trouble with spirit. They may be having trouble with alcohol. They may be having trouble with the Lord. Just like I'm preaching tonight. Oh, he'll set you free. I said he'll set you free. All you got to do is come. Set you free tonight. I said he can set you free tonight from every part, from everything, every sin, all the snares and all the trap, everything I'm doing, all that condemnation, he can set you free. Oh, give it to God tonight. Give it to Jesus. I said give it to Jesus tonight.
Oh, give it to God.
Oh, I've never seen to praise you. Glory to God. Yeah.
the Lord.
Jesus, you're talking to me.
Said, I need your help.
Just in the name. Give it to Jesus.
Satan and drugs and all these other things, God, they want to be set free. They want to be, they have a desire to be set free. But God, the devil has a mammon. Lord, if they come to you, they'll come to you, you'll loosen that. That spirit of you, God, will set them free tonight. Oh God, set them free tonight, I pray, in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen. Praise God.